A new law is giving Indiana families a new sense of hope tonight. It took effect July 1st and allows families who have lost loved ones to request Indiana State Police do a fresh investigation. WRTV Investigates, Kara Kenny spoke with families who are hoping to be the first to take advantage of this new law and get justice.
She was murdered. Yes, we believe her to have been murdered. Yes.
Donna Bell's daughter, Brittany, was found dead in her Kokomo home in 2017 with cuts and bruises on her body. Brittany's parents are now raising the children she left behind.
This is Kalila and this is Tyrese. Come here, Tyrese. And as you can see, they are little warriors. They've been beside us the whole time fighting for their mommy.
Brittany's autopsy lists cardiac dysrhythmia as the cause of death. That's an irregular heartbeat. But the coroner could not determine whether her death was natural, an accident, or a homicide. Brittany's manner of death was ruled undetermined. Kokomo police closed the case with no arrests. The family wants Indiana State Police to reopen and reinvestigate, including interviewing several people that were at Brittany's apartment around the time of her death. A new Indiana law, Senate Enrolled Act 177, allows families like the Bells to request Indiana State Police do a fresh investigation. Until now, ISP could only step in at the request of local law enforcement. Can't Stop, Won't Stop, a Michigan group dedicated to helping families get answers, helped the Bells put together a binder of information to present to state police. This is the first time her mom, Donna, is seeing it. Can't Stop, Won't Stop founder Lindsay Brink says their goal is to present the case with organized documentation.
Interviews from suspects, from witnesses. There's crime scene photos in there. There's just fact after fact after fact.
It's a moment this family has been waiting for 4 years.
And they wanted to present their mom's case to you today.
Okay.
A moment the Bells hope will get them answers in Brittany's death. The Bells aren't the only ones hoping to take advantage of the new law. Michelle Barton's son Tanner died in 2012. Howard County closed the case. The group submitted Tanner's binder to state police earlier this month.
Oh, it's exhilarating. It's what I've been waiting and wanting for 9 years.
The cause of Tanner's death? Positional asphyxia, meaning his body was positioned in a way that cut off his air supply. In 2018, an independent autopsy ruled the manner of death accidental, a change from the original autopsy, which listed it as natural. The Howard County Sheriff's Office pointed to Tanner's enlarged heart and Adderall use as factors in his death. Michelle says Tanner's case is plagued with inconsistencies, including the statements of his friends at the house that night.
I want to see those people held accountable. When you read through the binder, it's horrific what was done to Tanner. And I've been reading that binder every day since I received it. And I just keep seeing more stuff, and it's disgusting. And he deserves justice. He deserves somebody to be held accountable.
The new law requires families submit a request in writing to the superintendent of state police explaining why they have reasonable suspicion the death was the result of a criminal act. The family also has to notify local police and prosecutors that they're requesting ISP investigate. The new law applies only to uncharged deaths and does not apply if the loved one was under the care of a doctor or the death was the result of medical malpractice. The families and Can't Stop, Won't Stop acknowledge this is no guarantee charges will be brought. The Bells and the Bartons turn to Can't Stop, Won't Stop for help.
When I talk to families, I say, I am going to stick with you until we get your case in the right hands.
An important step of hope they can now take thanks to this new law.
Indiana State Police declined to comment for this story, and it's not clear how long it will take them to review these cases. Working for you, Kara Kenny, WRTV. We reached out to the Howard County Sheriff and Kokomo Police, and they tell us they have closed the cases of Brittany Bell and Tanner Barton. The sheriff says anyone with information about Tanner Barton's death can call the detective division at 765-456-2031. Both Can't Stop, Won't Stop and families tell us the information they provided proves criminal acts resulted in the deaths of their loved ones.